Welcome back to the student, welcome to the class. Today we will going to discuss the very important topic, that is the Lewis structure of various compounds. In the previous class we have discussed about the octet rule. Now let's make a fresh attempt on that so that we are able to understand that how does it works. The octet rule is a chemical rule of thumb that reflects the observation that main group elements tend to bond in such a way that each atom has 8 electrons in its valence shell, giving it the same configuration as exists in a noble gas. The rule is specially applicable to carbon, nitrogen, oxygen and halogens, but also to the metals like sodium or magnesium. So it indicates that it is applicable to what? Second period elements more effectively. Are you sure about that? Which tends to transform into neon. Sodium and magnesium being exceptional cases. They belong to third period. But they readily lose electron to give you what? To give you the neon configuration. The second thing you have to memorize that valence electron can be counted using a Lewis dot structure as shown at the right hand side where carbon dioxide is given. So here what could you see? You can see that carbon has how many? Carbon has 4 valence electron and oxygen has 6 valence electron. So how these atoms can be distributed? Here what happens that carbon 4 valence electrons are given by what? Are given by here in this formula by black dots, and oxygen electrons are shown by red dots. So here also what can we see? We can draw carbon valence electron like white dots and oxygen valence electron as yellow dots. Now in this way, what happens? In this way we have octet of carbon, this is octet of first oxygen, this is octet of second oxygen, and that is the octet of carbon. So you can easily see that how all the electrons around the atoms are what? Are 8 in numbers. Now to draw the Lewis structure of a compound, we have an elementary way. What is that elementary way? That hydrogen and lithium, they want to have 2 electrons around themselves, okay, because their nearest double gas is helium, while other elements they want to have 8 electrons around them because they have noble gas around them. So first you have to find out the value of Z. What is Z? Z is 8 into number of atoms other than hydrogen. That except hydrogen, the other atoms should be written plus 2 into number of atoms of hydrogen. So first calculate that, then after that you calculate what? You calculate the value of V. What is V? V stands for sum of the valence electrons of all the atoms in the compound plus any positive charge, if any positive charge is present there, plus means you have to add any negative charge present, minus any positive charge present. So what is that? Sum of valence electron of all the atom plus any negative charge minus any positive charge. Then you find out number of bonds. How many bonds are there? Answer here is Z minus V divided by 2. And then you have find number of lone pairs. That is number of bonds given by B. So number of lone pair given by which formula? The formula will be number of what? Number of valence electron minus twice of B divided by 2. So these are number of what? These are number of lone pairs. These are number of lone pair. V minus twice of B by 2. Are you getting that formula in your mind? So first you find out Z. Then you find out V. Then you find out number of bonds. Then you find number of lone pairs. So that's how you will find out. Now let's see how it works for carbonate ion. Okay. Now first find Z. So first find 8 into number of atoms other than hydrogen. So there is no hydrogen. So 0 hydrogen in this case. So look at what we have to find out. Z is what? 8 into number of atoms other than hydrogen. So you have 4 atoms, 3 oxygen and 1 carbon. Answer is 32. So value of Z is what? 32. Now what is V? 1 atom of carbon plus 3 atom of oxygen plus 2 negative charge present. So answer will be 1 into 4 plus 3 into 6 plus 2. So what is the answer here? 4 plus 18 plus 2, 24. So how many bonds are present here? Number of bonds. So how many bonds are present? Answer is 32. Minus 24 divided by 2. So what is the answer? Answer is 8 by 2. That is 4. So number of bonds is 4. So how many number of lone pair? Number of lone pair. Number of lone pair is how many lone pairs are present? So first you find out what is V. That is 24. Minus, what is the number of bonds? Answer is 4 bonds are there. Divided by 2. So answer will be 24 minus 8 divided by 2. So answer is 16 by 2. That is 8. So in carbonate, there are how many? There are four bond pair. There are four bond pair, and there are eight lone pair. So how would you find now? So draw carbon as a central atom here. So 1, 2, 3. Three oxygen are there now. So fourth bond. So one of the bond is what? One of the bond is double bond. So what can happen now? You have to represent what? How many lone pair are there? Eight lone pair. Now carbon has complete octet. 1, 2, 3, 4. All okay. So what can happen now? So you have to take into account oxygen. 1, 2, 3, 4. So three lone pair are here. Negative charge. 1, 2, 3. Three lone pair are there. Negative charge. And two lone pair are here. So you can see here that Lewis structure formula is very well represented. What is that? Now you can easily see that 8 electron around every atom. This carbon, this oxygen, this oxygen, this oxygen. So every atom has how many? You can count them. 8 electron around itself. So that's how you will represent the Lewis structure formula or satisfying the octet. So you should again see the formula. First find the value of Z. It is 8 into number of atoms other than hydrogen plus 2 into hydrogen. Then find V. Then find number of bonds. Then find number of lone pairs. And then you calculate it. Z for carbonate you are calculating now. Okay, sure. So now let's do it for ammonium cation. That is ammonium cation. Are you sure? So how many atoms are there? First find Z. So here one atom other than what? One atom other than hydrogen is present. So 8 into 1 plus 2 into number of hydrogen atom, that is 4. So answer is 8 plus 8 comes out to be 16. So what is V? V stand for one atom of nitrogen plus 4 atoms of hydrogen minus one positive charge. Remember that positive charge must be subtracted and negative charge must be added in V. So how many valence electrons in nitrogen? Answer is 5. How many valence are in hydrogen? Answer is 1. Minus 1. So answer will be 5 plus 4 minus 1. Answer is what? Answer is 8. So how would you find number of bonds? So number of bonds will be how many? Number of bonds will be Z minus V divided by 2. Z minus V divided by 2. So Z is 16, V is 8 divided by 2. So answer is 8 by 2, that comes out to be 4. So 4 bond pair around nitrogen. How many lone pair? Answer is what? Answer is V minus twice of B divided by 2. So V is 8, 2 into 4. So 8 minus 8 comes out to be 0. So there are no lone pair in ammonium. There is no lone pair in ammonium. 4 bond pair and no lone pair, 0 lone pair. That is the answer coming out to be. So now let's draw now. Nitrogen is a central atom. So here 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 bond pair in ammonium cation. There is no lone pair. So that is NH4 plus. Easy, that is too easy. So what can be the case here? Nitrogen is a central atom. Hydrogen. So what can be the case here now? There are how many? There are 8 electron around nitrogen and there is 2 electron around each hydrogen. So octet rule is completely satisfied. Now let's look at the about water molecule. Now in case of water, first find Z. What is Z? 8 into number of atoms other than hydrogen. So answer is 1. 2 into number of water molecules. So that is 2. So answer will be 8 plus 4. 12. What is V? V stands for 1 into hydrogen atom. Sorry, 2 into hydrogen atom plus 1 into oxygen atom. So answer will be 2 into valence electron 1, oxygen valence electron is 6. Answer is 8. So how many number of bonds are there? Bonds are Z minus V divided by 2. So Z is 12, V is 8. Divided by 2, answer is 4 by 2. So 2 are the number of bonds, number of lone pairs, so answer is V minus twice of B divided by 2. So how about V is 8, 2 into B is number of bonds divided by 2. So answer is 8 minus 4 divided by 2. Answer is 4 by 2, that is 2. So oxygen is the central atom. So 2 bond pairs are there. Okay, number of lone pairs is 2. So 2 lone pairs. 1 lone pair, that is second lone pair. Are you getting that? Sure? Very much sure. Hydronium ion, that is what? Hydronium ion. So there are 3 bond pair and 1 lone pair. How will you calculate that? First find Z. So what is Z here? Z here is 8 into number of atoms other than hydrogen, 1. 2 into number of hydrogen atom, that is 3. So answer is 8 plus 6, that is 14. What is V here? V stands for number of oxygen atom plus number of hydrogen atom minus, because positive charge is 1, so minus 1. So 1 into 6 plus 3 into 1 minus 1, answer is 8. So what is number of bonds? Number of bonds is Z minus V divided by 2. So 14 minus 8 by 2, 6 by 2 comes out to be 3. Number of lone pair. Number of lone pair will be V minus twice of B divided by 2. So what is V here? V here stands for 8. 8 minus 6 by 2. So answer is 1. So number of lone pair is 1 in hydronium ion. This ion is called hydronium ion. Are you sure? Clearly sure. Now in case of nitrate, you can find out here that 8 into number of atoms other than hydrogen is 4, so 32. So first find out V, it comes out to be 24. then find the number of bond, that is Z minus V by 2. So answer is 30. Nitrogen has 5 electron valence, oxygen has 6, negative charge is plus 1. So answer is 24, Z minus V by 2 comes out to be 4. And number of lone pair comes out to be V minus twice of B divided by 2. So that comes out to be 8. So number of bond pair 4, number of lone pair 8. So now let's move and see the structure. Nitrogen is the central atom and there are 4 bonds around itself. Okay, now here what can happen, just complete the octet. If you just complete the octet, you can see here also that I have put formal charges at points. Like oxygen has minus 1, oxygen had minus 1, nitrogen has plus 1. So minus 2 is the charge on 2 oxygen and plus 1 on nitrogen. So overall charge is what? Overall charge is nitrate. So now let's move forward and learn the formula of formal charge. Now the formal charge is very important property. In case of a polyatomic molecule, the difference between the number of valence electron in an isolated or free atom and number of electrons assigned to that atom in Lewis structure, that what is the position of the electron or difference in the position of the or counting of the electrons, the actual number of electron present on the atom and the number of electrons involved in bond pair and presence as a lone pair. So the formal charge formula is what? To count the formal charge, the formula is total number of valence electron in that atom minus number of electrons as lone pair around that atom, minus half number of electron as bond pair. So I am repeating once more, it is the total number of valence electron minus total number of electron present as what? So this is the formula you have to understand. What is the formal charge? Total number of valence electron in that atom minus number of electron as lone pair around that atom minus one half the number of electron as bond pair. So number of electron as the valence electron in that atom minus number of electrons around that atom as lone pair minus half number of electrons around as a bond pair around that atom. Are you getting that? Very much sure. So let's look at that formula in nitrate ion. Now first we'll have to find out what is nitrate ion here. So this is nitrate ion. Now if you look at its Lewis structure, then what you will see, so
Now here you can see that nitrate ion. So oxygen number here is X. That is Y. That is Z. And nitrogen you don't have number. So first find out around nitrogen. So formal charge around hydrogen. Sorry, nitrogen. So formal charge around nitrogen. What is that? So nitrogen has how many? Nitrogen has 5 electron as valence minus, in this case, 0 electron as what? 0 electron as lone pair minus 1 by 2. 8 electron as bond pair. So answer is 5. Answer is what? Answer is 1. So nitrogen has what? So nitrogen carry charge of plus 1. So nitrogen carry charge of what? Plus 1 in this case. Now charge on oxygen X. So oxygen X has how many valence electrons? Answer is 6. How many electrons are present here as lone pair? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. At X you can count 6 electrons as lone pair. Minus 1 by 2. How many electrons around it as lone bond pair? Answer is 2 only. 1 bond is there, so 2. So answer is 6 minus 6 minus 1. So overall answer is minus 1. So atom number X has charge of minus 1. So you can put here this value is minus 1. Okay. Similarly, charge on Y atom. Charge on atom Y. So oxygen is the atom Y. So how many valence electrons are there? Answer is 6. Minus. How many electrons are present as lone pair? Answer is 4. Minus half. How many electrons present as bond pair? Answer is 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 again. So answer is 6 minus 4 minus 2. Answer is 0. So at Y, answer is 0. That Y carry charge of 0. Atom Y, that is position Y of oxygen, it carry charge of 0 here in this case. Are you sure about that? Answer is very much sure. Now you can easily see that atom Z has also, atom Z has what? Same as scenario as X. So Z has also has charge of what? Minus 1. So in case of nitrate, what we have observed? In case of nitrate, we are observing that nitrogen carry charge of plus 1. Oxygen X carry charge of minus 1. Oxygen Z carry charge of minus 1. Or Y carry charge of 0. So X and Z have charge of minus 1. So plus 1 will cancel out minus 1. So it remains what? It remains only minus 1. So nitrate has charge of minus 1 only. Are you getting that? Very much sure.